A 57-year-old male has a lump in his cheek. Check out the full workup, treatment, and surprising rare diagnosis today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're talking about a bizarre oral pathology case that ultimately saved a man's life. This patient is a 57-year-old male who came to the office because he felt a lump in his cheek. He has noticed this mass for a few months. It isn't painful, and he has no other symptoms, but it hasn't gone away, so he's starting to get concerned. When I take a look at his lower facial third, I can see there is a visible mass in his left cheek. It's subtle, but we can make it out here. His intraoral exam shows a much more distinct mass. This lesion does not appear to involve the mucosa. The overlying epithelium is intact. This lesion is mobile, soft, and it's non-tender to touch and manipulation. He has no decreased sensation in his lip and chin, and also no lymphadenopathy. Okay, so we have a 57-year-old male with a submucosal mass in his left cheek that is asymptomatic and it's been present for at least a few months. What's on the differential diagnosis? The first lesion on my list is a lipoma, which is a slow-growing mass of adipose tissue, or fat. These lesions present just like this, a soft, mobile, submucosal mass. I actually have a really cool video on the channel of a lipoma surgery. It's actually one of my very first videos, so barely anybody watched it, but it's a great case if you want to see what a lipoma looks like and how it's removed. Another type of lesion on the differential is a benign minor salivary gland tumor, like a pleomorphic adenoma, a canalicular adenoma, or a PLGA. This could also be a malignant minor salivary gland tumor, like a mucoepidermoid carcinoma or adenoid cystic carcinoma. This lesion also has the appearance of a varicosity, albeit a large one. My plan is to approach this lesion from the oral mucosa, expose it, dissect around it, and remove it in its entirety. This is done under local anesthesia in the office. Once this patient is anesthetized, I make an incision through the mucosa and attempt to identify the lesion. A lipoma is easily identifiable. It is a yellow, well-defined mass. I'm expecting it to reveal itself at any moment, but there is no large collection of adipose tissue in this area. Okay, so lipoma is off the list. Now I'm looking for a well-defined mass, like a pleomorphic adenoma or a varicosity. Nothing. Now I'm starting to get concerned. This is not an isolated growth. Instead, this is an area full of disorganized, friable tissue with no clear surgical planes and no identifiable mass. This is when I pivot my thinking on this case. I originally thought this was a benign lesion, but now I have major concerns for a malignant primary lesion or a metastatic lesion. I get plenty of tissue samples and then close the site primarily. This is the kind of case where I immediately get on the phone afterwards and ask the pathologist to expedite the report. Time is of the essence, and the sooner I get the diagnosis, the sooner we can begin treatment. I anxiously awaited this diagnosis, and it wasn't what I was expecting. This lesion turned out to be a MALT lymphoma, or a mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue lymphoma. MALT lymphoma is a slow-growing, non-Hodgkin lymphoma. It's rare, with an estimated 5,000 new cases in America each year. Most malt lymphomas are found in the stomach. They can also be found in the lungs, skin, and occasionally in the salivary glands, as in this case. Thankfully, this is a slow-growing lymphoma, and it can be treated in a variety of ways, including localized radiation therapy, chemotherapy, and monoclonal antibodies. Malt is often associated with an H. pylori infection, so part of the treatment regimen is antibiotics. I referred this patient to hematology oncology. He was treated with monoclonal antibodies and did very well. He made a full recovery and is now living cancer-free. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out my website, theopenreduction.com, for all kinds of information to help hone your surgical skills. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.